Everybody, it's Paige Evans, and I have a new process video to share with you today. This is a layout created for the Pink Paisley blog, focusing on these mini origami hearts. So I'm starting by trimming a piece of double-sided pattern paper to 2 inches square. I'm using my new collection with Pink Paisley called Truly Grateful. Again, 2-inch square, and then you fold it in half diagonally both ways, so corner to corner, open it up, fold it the other corner to corner. And then you want to bring one of the corners to the center, fold the crease, and then turn it 180 and bring that bottom corner up to the top edge, and then fold these sides up and you're almost finished. Turn it over and fold the top corners over to the edge, and then just fold these corner pieces over. That's it. Easy peasy. Takes about 1 minute to create each origami heart. So I made a whole bunch of them. I only end up using about a third of them, but I'll have them for later projects. I trimmed this pattern paper in half diagonally, and I just like the contrast of these two colors. It's kind of a raspberry pink and a salmony pink. And I'm going to adhere it in place using super sticky double-sided tape around the edges, and then I'll fill it in the center with an adhesive roller, and then peel off the backing from the double-sided tape, and it's ready to be adhered in place. And I just did this for some fun interest on the background, just to have a two-tone design. And then to help the hearts pop off the background a little bit more, I'm going to add some white gesso. So I squirted a little bit in the middle, and I'm using my fingers to rub it in place. Again, this just softens up the background a little bit, so the colors are toned down on the background, but it helps the pattern paper hearts stand out. And I just added a little bit of water to help make it spread around a little bit easier. And then I am coming in with watered down bright white acrylic paint and splashing it on top. Again, this just creates another layer of interest and texture on the background. I also sped up the drying process with a hairdryer because nobody has time to wait for paint to dry. So I just keep a hairdryer right next to my table. And so then I placed the hearts in place. I didn't adhere them down yet. I just wanted to get an idea of where I wanted them to go, and then I'm hand drawing these lines in spirals and swirls, kind of like balloons floating off into the air. That was kind of the look I was going for. So I just winged it, drawing some swirls from the hearts to the center, or to the bottom left corner where I plan to have my photo. And then I machine stitched over those drawn hearts, and I am using an eraser to erase the leftover pencil marks, so that it's just the stitched swirls that are left. Trimmed off the excess threads, and then this is the photo I'm going to use of me and my daughter Jane down here on the bottom left corner. And then placing the hearts back in place at the ends of the stitched trails. Now, I didn't end up using all of these colors. I took off the yellows and oranges, and I did use glue dots to attach them in place, but I started gluing them down and realized I didn't want all of these colors. I just picked and chose a few colors. So here you can see the colors of the hearts that I ended up using. And then to embellish, I'm adding a few puffy stickers here and there, again in this chosen color palette. Just placing them in the open spaces on top of the stitched lines. This adds texture and interest. For the title, I auditioned some of these epoxy stickers, but I couldn't figure out the right placement, so I actually didn't end up using a large title. It's just one of the sentiment stickers. So here again, I'm just trying to figure out where to put a title. Thought about using the good stuff, and added a couple sentiment stickers from the 6x12 sticker sheet that went along with this photo. And the last step is to write some journaling. I wrote 3 lines with a pencil and then wrote my journaling, and I'll go over it with a black pen. And that's the finished layout. I hope you are inspired to try making these Little origami hearts, once you start, you can't stop. They're so fun to make and fun to use on your layouts. Thanks for watching, and I will see you again soon.